Now, if you're looking at getting the Google Pixel 6 and wondering if 128 gigabytes is enough, I'm here to tell you absolutely. Now, there are two gig sizes for this phone. If you're looking to get it, you can get it in 128 or the 256. The thing about getting the 256 is that it's going to run you $100 more. And honestly, guys, 128 gigabytes is definitely enough storage. Now, I also want to go over five reasons why this phone is worth getting, because it is one of my favorite releases from Google ever. It's got a completely revamped design on it that looks great. So let's get into some of those reasons. Now, the phone currently sells for $599. It's got a revamped design from the Pixel 5. Instead of the aluminum design the phone previously had, it's now all glass. And the thing looks amazing. I'd actually rank this as one of the best looking phones to release this year. Now, the first reason I'd recommend you get this phone is twofold. The battery life is going to be better than most phones out there, especially for the price point. Now, it's got around a 4,000 mAh built-in battery that'll give you a lot of standby time, but the thing will last well over a day. I mean, we're looking at 2+ days of battery life before it runs out of juice. The other reason I would say is the storage on this starts at 128 gigs, which is honestly plenty of storage for most people. I kind of feel like it's hard to fill that up, 64 gigs for sure. But yeah, you can see storage-wise, 128 gigs. So yeah, first two reasons, storage is good, and then the battery life on this phone is amazing. Now, the next reason I think it's worth buying is the camera is great for phone photography. So it's got a 12-megapixel back camera. I'm going to pull up an example picture here. This was my Starbucks I drank this morning. But it's got a 50-megapixel zoom on it, and it can record in 4K at 30 frames per second. But for phone photography purposes, it's a really nice phone, guys. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm just doing a little zoom in right there. Of course, if you have any questions specifically about the camera on this phone, feel free to message me below in the comments. But then, of course, you're looking at the display on this. It's got a 6.4-inch AMOLED display, and it's got the new Google Tensor chip in it. Now, I'm going to run like a one-minute clip so you guys can see that you get most of the display on this phone. There's really no notch on the bottom or top, and the sound quality is really good as well. And before we get more into this, I want to recommend everyone check out the Binance US app. Now, this is my go-to cryptocurrency trading app that I highly recommend checking out, especially if you're not in crypto right now. Now, cryptocurrency is a great way to make money using your phone. So if you guys want to learn more about Binance US or get started, we'll have some bonus sign up and resource links in both the description and comments. Next, I'm going to get into performance on this phone and play some Marvel Contest of Champions. Now, I've been playing this game a lot lately. It's one of my favorite fighting games. It's high graphic, and I think it's just a good game to test out a new phone with. I'm actually going to zoom in so you guys can see a little bit closer. Now, like I said, you do get all of the display on this phone, which is nice. It's also got Gorilla Glass on the front of it, so it doesn't really scratch easy, which is a plus. And the loudness is really good as well. So yeah, it's got this Google Tensor chip in it. That's what it's called, the new chipset. That's kind of what they're pushing a lot, you know, trying to sell this phone. And the phone's fast. It's been pretty close matching it up with like the iPhone 12 and iPhone 13, the Galaxy S21. It actually beat it out a little bit in my speed comparison. Anyways, I'm going to get into a couple fights here. And then I'm going to give you my final thoughts on if I think this phone is worth buying. It looks like we've got Iron Man versus Captain America. So we've got like the special Iron Man. He's got like a clear color. It's a nice blast right there. All right, nice. All right, I'm gonna switch up the character. We'll use Colossus. He's pretty cool. Alright, Hawkeye getting us a little bit here. I feel like one punch should probably knock Hawkeye out, but, you know, he's holding his own here. All right, nice. I'm actually going to throw up one more game real quick, Altos Odyssey, and play this for about a minute. Okay, so just to recap on the five reasons the Google Pixel 6 is worth buying, it's got great battery life, a beautiful design. Like I said, it's probably one of the best looking phones to release this year. You get plenty of storage. It's got a 6.4-inch AMOLED display, which is big. The price point makes sense at $599. And last but not least, the camera on it is really good for phone photography. Okay, anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Tap that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and we'll see you in the next video.